Hi, my name is Gary Eckstein. For my regular viewers, well, today I'm not talking about MailChimp. Today I'm going to show how we can use Amazon AWS to create subtitles for our YouTube videos. Subtitles, in my opinion anyway, are absolutely critical, both for accessibility reasons, but also for SEO reasons. A subtitle is let's call it a transcription of a video with timings attached. YouTube, when you upload your video, normally creates these for you. On occasion it doesn't, or maybe the subtitles aren't that great. You can use something like Amazon AWS to create subtitles. There are a few kind of steps to go through with AWS, with Amazon AWS, so I'll illustrate those. I'm in Amazon AWS at the moment, and I've uploaded my video, my MP4 video in this case, up into a bucket, into AWS S3. It's critical, you have to upload your video or your audio file up into S3. But let me go across to Amazon or AWS Transcribe, but I could search for it, but I'm going to click on Amazon Transcribe. And Amazon Transcribe will create the subtitles for us. I already have one here, but let's create a new job. So I'm going to click create job. I can call it anything I want to. So what I'm going to do here is in Transcribe, I'm going to say to Transcribe, look at that file, that MP4 file in this case, that I uploaded to my S3 bucket. Look at that and extract the audio, the text from that. I can call it anything I want to. You would name it something meaningful. You then can fill in the various options. I'm just going to use a general model in this case. I'm going to use a specific language, and I'm going to change this language to Australian. Yeah, I have a bit of an accent. I grew up in South Africa. I lived in England. Now I live in Australia. But I'll just, the closest is probably English Australian. There are various additional settings, but I don't worry too much about that. But then our input data. This is that video file or audio file we uploaded into S3, AWS S3, as we looked at a few seconds ago. So I'll click Browse S3. I'm going to click on my bucket name, and there's that file there that I uploaded earlier. And I'll click Choose. I will just leave the defaults here and then click Next near the bottom of the screen. You can change the defaults if you want to, but I'm going to leave the defaults and click Create. So once I've clicked Create, you'll see it's in progress. So what's happening now is Amazon Transcribe is going off to that file in my S3 bucket. It's going through and it's creating text from that and putting timings onto it. So just to speed this, it's actually incredibly quick, but just to speed up the process a little bit, I've got one I've created in the past. So when I'm ready and I want to add the subtitles to YouTube, what I do is I click the name of the file, AWS gives me various details, but I then download the full transcript. I'll just open it up on a different screen, sorry, just give me one second. I'll just open it up so you can see what it looks like. So a JSON file has downloaded, and it looks very odd. And to be absolutely honest, you cannot use this. This is not a CRT or an acceptable file type that YouTube recognizes. This is a specific AWS Transcribe file type or schema. So what we actually need to do is copy all this stuff. So I'm going to copy it. Then there is a tool online, yash.info/AWS SRT creator. So what we can do in this tool is we can paste in that JSON, click create SRT, and it converts it into the SRT file type, which is an acceptable file type for subtitles. But you'll notice certain things aren't right here, such as it says here, organic space, web space, etc. And maybe, so what I need to do is go through and just make sure everything's okay. So I'll just highlight all the content that's been generated, copy that. What I'm going to do in this case is go back into Visual Studio Code, but you can use Notepad, anything like that. I'll just create a new file and I'll just paste in that information that that converter from JSON to SRT gave me. So here it is here. Just a tip that when we do this, often they're these sort of empty lines that are output with undefined. So what I need to do is go through and find all these undefined and delete them. I don't need to renumber. So for example, it's consecutive numbering, 4, 5, 6, 7. I can just delete it. I can leave the numbering. That's absolutely fine. I'll just delete it there. And let me just go through very quickly. There's another undefined. So let me delete that. And I'll just go through, just make sure there are no more. There's another one. Let's delete that. Go through and there it looks like is the last one. Okay. Right, so what we would do then is go through and just check that everything's okay and replace things where they aren't right. Organicweb.com.au, for example. And what you'll notice is MailChimp, where I can, oh, there we go. MailChimp in AWS always comes out, the translation, the way I speak it, my accent, comes out as male, as in the gender, chimp. So what I'll do is I'll just change that quickly. Let's just do a replace all. Let's just change this to MailChimp. Okay, and we'll just make sure that it's all done. Okay. What did I do wrong there? Oh, there we go. Okay. So let's just assume it's not right yet, but let's just assume this is all okay. What I need to do is save this as an SRT file. So I click File. Well, I'm in the Visual Studio Code, but as again, you could be using Notepad or similar. And I'll just save this, click Save, and I can save it anywhere. And I just need to save it as an extension, not of TXT in this case, but of SRT. So I'm just changing the extension, clicking Save. Okay, so let's go back. Now, I've got my SRT file, so I've got my transcription file. So in YouTube, you can upload your video. Then in Studio, YouTube Studio, just click on Subtitles to the left-hand side of the screen. Then on the video that you've uploaded that you want to add the subtitle files, you'll be able to add it. You merely click Add and it'll say upload your file and you just choose that SRT file you've just created and you've created your subtitle file. So let me just summarize this very quickly because there are quite a few steps. We first upload, our video file to Amazon AWS S3. Then we go to Amazon Transcribe, and we transcribe it. It outputs a JSON file, which we download. We then go to this URL. We convert it into SRT. We put it into a file in a text editor. We cleanse it, make it sure it looks okay, get rid of those undefined lines. We save it as an SRT file. We upload our video to YouTube, and then in Subtitles in YouTube Studio, we merely upload that SRT file that we created. And that's how we can go off and create subtitle files in an external service such as AWS and import them into YouTube. But please subscribe to my channel. I'm Gary from organicweb.com.au.